all of you. I am audible to all. Please let me know. Hello. Okay, I am audible. Please let me know, please. Good afternoon to all of you. I am audible to all or not? Please let me know. I'm just waiting for your replies. So just interact with me, please, and let me know whether you are able to, you know, listen to me. Whether my voice is clear, everything is fine. Okay, so just type in this live chat so that I will be able to, you know everything whether you are getting or not. So please, I think why we are not able to get the messages. Let me check again. Getting your messages. So please let me know whether you are getting my voice and whether we are not able to chat here. Very good afternoon to all of you. Are you able to see me? Are you able to listen to my voice? Let me ask you in brief. I think I am not able to get your messages. Are you able to get my messages or not? Everything is fine here on my side. So please type here. Very good afternoon to all of you. Are you able to listen to my voice or not? Are you able to get my voice? Are you able to listen to me, or is there any type of, you can say, noise in between? Something is like that, then please let me know. Check me this live chat, please. To see your messages. good afternoon to all of you. Now I am able to, you know, see your messages. So first of all, I welcome all of you in this today, you can say, first class of our Kingdom Animalia. So I am just welcoming all of you. So we have Shubham, Sani along with us. Good afternoon, Shubham. How are you? We have Deepak. We have Liston. I'm very sorry if I pronounce your name wrong. And please let me know whether I am pronouncing it right or not. So, and then we have Pankaj. We have Shivangi with us. Gayatri is also here. Gayatri, actually, yes, I am taking your 8 p.m. lecture. It is just another lecture series which will be started today by 3 p.m. and it's Kingdom Animalia. Okay, so we will meet at 8 p.m. Then we have Indra Nath, we have Pankaj Kumar, and we have Baiban with us. Yes, Gitika, it's another class, not your own class. We have Falguni with us. We have Somo Shri with us. Moses, good afternoon. How are you, Moses? Then we have Divyani with us. Ellen, how are you, Ellen? So I am just welcoming all of you in this Animalia lecture series. And I am just wishing that all you will be fine in your homes and everywhere. So if it is possible, if you are able to listen to my voice, Yes, very very good afternoon to all. And Pankaj is saying disturbances in the background. It may be because of the fan. So when I will start the session, I will just switch off the fan, no issue. Okay, so don't worry, Pankaj. We have Kumarjit with us. Good afternoon, Kumarjit, how are you? And from where you are, please let us know. Megha, how are you, Megha? Yes, Justin Andrews, good afternoon, Justin, how are you? Yes, Falguni, good afternoon. So a very good afternoon to all of you in this 10 days lecture series in which we have to cover basically the Kingdom Animalia. Okay, very good. Actually, right now I am in my university and I have some, you can say, network issue, or not only the network issue but also a light problem. So I just shifted from my chair to this way, so that you will be able to see me, and also the network will be fine here. So how are you all, and from where you all belong? I also there along with your chat when we have discussed it yesterday. So please let me know something about yourself. From where you all are and in which class you are basically. We have Kumarjit here. Kumarjit saying, ma'am, I am fine. Okay, very good, Kumarjit. So please let me know from where you all belongs to, and something if you want to tell me about yourself. Somo Shri is also here. It's audible, there is lots of noise. Okay, just let me just switch off the fan, then you will be able to listen it clearly. Okay, just 1 minute. So I think it will be, we can say, it will be much clearer to you now. It's audible to you now because I have just switched off the fan. This noise is of the fan only. Yes. Yes, Somoshri, I just switched off the fan. I think now it's okay. Please let me know, everything is fine now? Or is there any type of, you can say, trouble or noise in between now also? My voice is clear to you? Yes, please let me know. And one more thing, is showing the biochemistry, basically the thumbnail is of biochemistry, but I will change it definitely today. It is an Animalia section. At 8 p.m. I am taking the biochemistry class, so that's why it is showing the notification of biochemistry only. So no issues regarding it. I will change it later, okay? So just let me know whether now everything is fine. My voice is clear. Please let me know. My voice is audible to you and it is clear, or is there any type of noise now? Yes, we have Deepak. Deepak, how are you, Deepak? Good afternoon, Deepak. Shivangi, good afternoon. The Nature. Give us your good name, The Nature. Please let me know. We have Devyani, we have Liston, and we have Somushri. So I am really sorry if I am not pronouncing your name right or correct. Then you have to tell me, ma'am, this is my name. Then I will definitely try to, you can say, pronounce it right. So please let me know. Yes. Okay. Good. Yes, now voice is clear. Okay. So, The Nature, what is your good name? Because The Nature is not your name. So please let me know what's your name, because I will pronounce you by your name only. So please let me know what's your good name. Then it will be, you can say, kind of you. Yes, we have Pankaj. How are you, Pankaj? Everything is fine. We have Liston from Tamil Nadu. So I'm really sorry if I'm pronouncing your name incorrect. Then please correct me, okay? We have Devyani, we have Elin, we have Shubham. Shubham is from University of Delhi. Okay. So how are you, Shubham? And what is the situation of, you know, this pandemic in Delhi right now? Is it curable now? Is everything is fine now? Please let me know. Okay. So The Nature's full name is Shivam. Okay, very good, Shivam. Very good. Shivam Kumar Maurya. Okay, good. Yes, and The Nature is his channel. Oh, very good. And how much subscribers are there in your channel? How much subscribers? Shivam Kumar Maurya. Okay, very nice. And we have Moses from Nagpur. Welcome, Moses. How are you? Actually, because tomorrow I'm not able to interact with all of you, so I just want to interact with you first so that I will be able to know about and something about you, and also you will be able to know something about me. Okay, Shubham is saying the situation is fine. No, he is fine, but the situation is still critical in Delhi. Okay, so the Nature has 120 subscribers. Okay, very good, Nature. Keep it up. And just share me your link. I will definitely subscribe you. So it's actually you can say effort of any student. If instead of studying, the student is doing such type of activities, so it takes a lot of effort. So we have to encourage or we have to motivate that student. Okay. Yes, Ellen, I'm fine. Thank you. Yes. Ellen, I have done my lunch. Thank you. So now my voice is audible. I hope so. You are getting me. And we have Somushri. She is from West Bengal. Okay. So Somushri, how is the situation of this pandemic in West Bengal right now? Are you going to colleges? Please let me know. Or you are doing online classes, all of you? We have Ellen. We have another student. Shubham, we have Elan and Moses. So yes, Elan is from Kerala. So Elan, I am pronouncing your name right. It's Elan. So I just want to know that how are you going to colleges or universities, or you are doing this online education right now? Please let me know. Okay, online classes. So Shubham is saying online classes. Right now you have 4-5 months with these online classes, so maybe you all get bored of it, maybe, or you just miss your colleges or universities or your friends. Yes. Pankaj is from Rajasthan. Welcome, Pankaj. Online classes, okay. And then we have Dixit. Dixit is also from Kerala. How are you, Dixit? Everything is fine on your side? Please let us know if everything is fine. Okay, Baiban is also here. Baiban is from Mumbai. Yes, they are hectic than offline one. Yes, because first time, that is in the beginning, we are founding a very new technique of this online, you can say online classes. But now What happens, like I am a teacher, now I have to teach all of you, but I am unable to see your faces. Okay, I am unable to see your reactions. So that is the only thing which I misses. I just miss when I am doing the regular classes or the online platform. So just I want to, you know, request all of you to just give me your expressions in the form of messages, whether you are getting it, whether you are not getting it, okay? So that I am able to know everything is going right or not, because I am not able to see you all. So that is the one thing which I want to request all of you, okay? Okay, so we have Divyani Sharma. How to make interest in Animal Kingdom, and I am excited to join this program. Yes, yes, the excitement will definitely be there, Divyani, in the 10th lecture also. So need not to worry, we will definitely have lots of fun and lots of things to learn, the new things to learn. So I welcome you Divyani. We have Kumarjit Golden. Golden is from Madhya Pradesh, Indore. Okay, Golden, your name is very unique, Golden. Like Golden is the golden. So please let me know, your name is very unique one. Then we have, we have medical biochemistry for medical students. So please let me know, is it only a one student or? Because the name is medical biochemistry for medical students. So please, the person or the student who is typing the message, please let me know your good name and from where you belong, so that I am able to, you know, start conversation with you also. So please let me know your name. Medical biochemistry for medical students. Please let me know your name. Okay, listen is saying, thank you ma'am, you are pronouncing it correctly. Okay, thank you. So we have very, very good students along with us. So you all are doing by this online mode or online classes. But your classes are from 9 to 2 p.m. or how long it takes? Because our classes are from 3 to 4:30. So definitely your classes will be from 9 to 2 p.m. Is it like that? Or you are missing your classes for this session? Please let me know. Are you missing the classes for this session or you are free at that time? We have Rakesh G.R. Welcome Rakesh. We have Horam Zad. I'm really sorry, I'm not pronouncing it right maybe. So it's Abaida. So I just you know pronounce it Abaida. So Abaida is with us. Now let me know whether your classes are from 9 to 2 p.m. and you are free by this 3 p.m. for this 3 session. Yes, Golden is saying yes ma'am, he's happy because of his unique name, Golden Gokhale. Yes, it's only the first time I listen to the name Golden, because Golden is generally the ornaments which we wear, which we all wear. So it's a very good name and very unique name basically. So from where Golden, where what are you studying right now and from where you are? I think you tell me. Yes, you are pursuing PhD in Limnology from Indore. Okay, good. Yes, just we are interacting because just so that one or more of the students which are left, they will join with us. Till then, please let me know that your classes are from 9 to 2 p.m. How long you have your online classes? Are you free on this 3 p.m. section or not? Please let me know. Horam Zad Nale. Huh? Okay, Shivangi is saying that the classes are suspended at the moment for Puja vacation. Okay. ओके ओके सो यू हैव योर क्लासेस बाय 9 to 2 PM 9 to 2 PM Divyani, actually not 6 PM because I have continuously classes, the online classes. In the morning I have my university classes, then from 3 PM I have your class, then after it by 5:30 I have another session for 2 hours, and then by 8 PM I have another session for 2 hours. So I am completely busy up to 10 PM. So I'm really sorry. We have to take this class on 3 PM. Maybe on Saturday or Sunday we will shift it either on the in the beginning also or in the late also. So but this flexibility will be only at the Saturday or Sundays only. So Nitya is saying this is my first course here and I am very excited for this course. Yes, yes, definitely you will get, you will able to learn lots of new things which are there around us, but we are sometimes not focusing on these things. So Divyani has classes up to 5 PM. Okay, Moses classes has not started yet. Dixit saying, yes ma'am, I'm a working professional, will have time to attend the sessions. Okay, very good Dixit. So Dixit, may I allow to ask you in which profession basically you are? Please let us know. Yes, this time is comfortable for all of you because you have done your lunch and now you know you can even be on your bed and just listen to the lecture. So I think this timing should be best for all of you. It's not too early and it's not too late, and you are always you all are in your comfortable state basically. You have not to go outside or nothing like that. So maybe you all are comfortable at 3 PM. Then we have Divyani. Yes, she is also a science teacher. Okay, welcome Divyani. Science TGT teacher. Okay, welcome to you. So you are also taking the online classes, Divyani? Means you are also taking the online classes of the students. Yes, okay, good, very good. Yes, Moses, it's definitely related to the, you know, the thing in which you are registered. So basically I have to teach all of you, you know, something which is there in front of our eyes but we are not able to get it. I will start and you all will let to know. So no worries. Okay, Divyani is saying I usually teach in person too. Okay, very good Divyani, just keep it up. We have Dixit, I am totally new to the biology background. I am from aerospace background, okay. And now he is preparing for IFS. So all the best Dixit for the civil services exams. So even my cousin brother is also an IFS officer, and he also opted botany and zoology for his exams, and now he is working in Punjab basically in a forest department. So I just wish you all the best because you have done aerospace. If you are able to do aerospace or the engineering in aerospace, something like that, then you are very able to understand this our zoology or botany or biology basically. So I welcome you. Yes, and I am just wishing you all the best for your future, you know, this perspective or your future goals. And if you will be there, I am just start from the very basic techniques or the very basic things. So if you not only Dixit, but if all of you are able to understand the basics, to understand what the basics which are there, then you will be able to pursue it further in your any another exam. So if basics is clear, then nothing is difficult. But if basics are not clear, then it's very difficult to do the complex things. So yes, I hope you are getting my point. Bible, no. In this session, in this Kingdom Animalia, I just keep it very simple. That simple that you are able to get everything. Animal behavior, I will make another session for animal behavior in which we will study animal behavior. So yes, one thing is left. Now it's my time to introduce myself. So myself is Dr. Amneet Kaur. I am from Chandigarh. I have done my master's in honors from Punjab University, Chandigarh. Then I pursue my PhD also there in Punjab University. And my topic is basically on molecular entomology. So basically my work is on insects, the small creatures, the insects. And I have done molecular analysis on those insects. I have done the molecular techniques which are there, like you can say DNA isolation, PCR, gene level studies, phylogenetic analysis, phylogenetic software. So I have covered all these things. But today, the session which we have selected, the Kingdom Animalia, is a very basic or very simple kingdom. But you will get to know so much of things when, you know, the days will pass. Because today is the first day, it will be very simple. But as the days will pass, you will be able to know that so many things are there which we all are not aware about, okay? So as I come to know from your introduction that you all are maybe from different fields, or maybe you are also new to Kingdom Animalia. So I will try my best to keep this journey, you know, more excited and new to you. So are you getting my point? And is it okay? Are you able to understand what I want to say? Like if you are in close relationship with nature, if you like nature, if you like dogs, if you like animals, the creatures, then definitely this session will be, you know, so much excited for all of you. Definitely. Yes. So yes, we have Falguni, we have Listen, we have Shivangi, then we have Abaida, we have Moses, we have Kumarjit, we have Baiban. Okay, so I think that's all for our introductory. Now let's start the session. So are you ready? Shall we start it now? I think everything is okay now. Voice is clear. Let me share the PPT first and tell me whether you are getting it or not getting it. Okay? Let me share the PPT with all of you. Yes, here we are. And definitely I will share everything, this PPTs and another information with all of you. So just focus on the basics or the concepts only. I will send everything to you, no issues at all. It takes a little bit more time. Sometimes the files are quite heavy, so it takes some time. Yeah, it's open now. So are you able to see this frog or the creature? Are you able to see this? Please let me know. Okay. Moses is a wildlife photographer and naturalist and a dog lover. Okay. So are you able to see the PPT? Please let me know so that we will start it. Okay. Please let me know. So shall I start? Yes, Natasha. Hello, how are you, Natasha? Okay, so now I will move forward to the PPT. In between the PPT, in between the PPT, I will come back on this YouTube live stream, and then we will interact with each other, okay? So we will take some break of 2 or 5 minutes, then we will interact. So let's start, okay? So Natasha, I welcome you. Now we will start the PPT first. So what's this? So yes, so we have to deal the kingdom Animalia, but before kingdom Animalia we have some terms which we must know, like classification, taxonomy. These are some basic terms in the field of biology. So we must know these terms first, then we will move towards the kingdom Animalia and the creatures which are, or the organisms which are there in the kingdom Animalia. So first, there are 13 billion known species of organisms. So we have 13 billion different types of organisms around us. This is only 5% of all organisms that are ever lived. So this is only the 5%. New organisms are still being found and identified. So we have so many, you can say, new species or new organisms are there which are not identified yet, and we have to identify those new organisms. So which are not identified yet. So basically, what is the classification, or why we need this classification? Because we have so much of unidentified organisms, so we need a proper type of pattern which we have to follow. So classification is the arrangement of organisms into the orderly group based on, based on their similarities. So what basically what classification is? It is the arrangement of organisms into the orderly groups based on their similarities. So if we have some type of similarities, like dogs have some type of similarities, so they will be placed in a one group. Or you can say cats have some type of similarities, so cats will be placed in another group, and dogs and cats will not be placed in one group because they have dissimilarities. So only the similar organisms will be, you can say, placed in a single group. So classification is also known as taxonomy. Classification is basically what? It is the arrangement of the organisms, that how the organisms are arranged. Taxonomists are scientists that identify and name organisms. So what happened in taxonomy? We will discuss it in detail in the upcoming slides. Basically in taxonomy what happens? Suppose you go in the marine or you go in the sea and you found something living creature, okay? Or sometime what happens, you go in the forest and you found some, some another type of butterflies which have not seen before, something like that you can see. So we have to identify the thing, that what it is, whether the specimen is butterfly or moth or you can say honeybee, what it is basically, and then we have to name the organism. The name, if we are not able to identify it, then we have taxonomists who identify the specimen and then they name the organism. So why we are doing this classification? What's the need of doing this to give the name to the organism? Why we are doing this? Why? Because accurately and uniformly named organisms prevents misnomers, such as starfish and jellyfish are not real fish. So if you are all know that we have starfish and we have jellyfish, but both are not, neither starfish nor jellyfish, they are not fishes. Okay, they are not fishes, they are not a real fishes. Their name is only starfish. So if we are giving the same name to some organisms, or the, you can say, artificial name, then it will cause misnomers. Suppose in your class, if we have two students whose name is Rahul, okay, then it will become very difficult to identify that who is this Rahul or who is another Rahul. So that is why we have to classify the organisms, we have to give them the names basically. So use the same languages for all names. So all languages we have used same type of, you can say, language. Now what is this basically? This is a seahorse. The name of the organism is seahorse, but it is not a horse either, and it is found in the water, in the deep ocean. So we have to keep it in mind that misnomer should not be there. So like this. Now this is some, suppose this is some organisms. So confusion in using different languages for names. So this one is saying it something else. This ma'am is saying it something chichi or something, and this is saying something. So we have to do that. What we have to do? We have to make it a single name only, because we are living in a diverse countries. Each one will pronounce it accordingly. But we have to give the organism the single, the authentic name basically. So what now we have done, we have provided them the latest name, or you can say Greek names, like the name. Now everyone is pronouncing the same name, which is Mephitis Mephitis. So this is its scientific name, this is its scientific name. Like the scientific name of human is, the man's scientific name is Homo sapiens. So this is Mephitis Mephitis is the scientific name of this organism. So instead of giving it so many of names, we have to provide the one original scientific name. So these are the early taxonomists. Like we have Aristotle, you must have heard about him. He was the first taxonomist. About 2000 years ago, he was the first person who said that plants are, this group consists of plants and this group consists of animals. Are you able to get it? Otherwise how we will categorize the things, how we will able to know whether they are plants or they are animals? So Aristotle is the first one who placed two groups. One is the plants and another is animals. So in plants it includes the plants, the flowers, the fruit bearing trees, and in animals the walking animals, the creatures who are running. So all these comes under the animals. He subdivided them by their habitat, land, sea or air dwellers. So there is another further, you can say, subdivision also, in which we are able to divide them according to their habitat where they are living. Then we have another scientist whose name is John Ray. He was the first to use Latin for naming. So John Ray is the one who said that instead of giving different names, we have to give only a single scientific name to the organism. Okay, his names were very long, descriptions telling everything about the plant. So like this is the name of the plant, D. plantis in genere. So by this he is able to tell everything about the organism for which he is providing the scientific name. So this is John Ray. Then after it we have Linnaeus. He is also very famous taxonomist. So who is the taxonomist basically? Who identify the organism and give name to the organism is known as taxonomist. If you are able to see any organism and you say this is the moth and the name of this moth is this one, so then you will become the taxonomist. Like some students are also there who are, you know, pursuing photography as his or her passion. So they also become taxonomists because they are in, you can say, contact with the nature. So Linnaeus is one, classified organism by their structure. So according to the structure of the organism, Linnaeus is able to classify the organisms. Okay, then we have, yes, it's his journal Systema Naturae. Then we have Linnaeus, who is known as father of taxonomy. Why? Because he developed the modern system of naming known as binomial nomenclature. The nomenclature which we are, you can say, following till now. So the scientist is in The scientist is in 17th century, not sorry, in 18th century, that is in 1707 to 1778, but he described some, you can say, some technique, or he is the one who developed the system of knowing, of naming, known as binomial nomenclature, and this nomenclature is still we are following. Okay, so Linnaeus is very much important in the field of taxonomy, and in binomial nomenclature, what basically he told us that we have to name the organism along with its genus and species. So if my name is Homo sapiens, my name or human's name is Homo sapiens, so Homo is basically genus and sapien is the species. I will let you know what it is basically. So like they are just describing some patterns of how to write the nomenclature. Generally the nomenclature or the name is write in the italics. I will let you show here. So this is the name of this bird. It's Turdus migratorius. Turdus migratorius, and it is written in italics. Or its general name, or according to the location where the bird is present, is American robin. But its scientific name is Turdus migratorius. So Turdus is the genus and migratorius is the species of this bird. Otherwise its common name or its home name is American robin. Okay, are you able to get it or not? Like we have giant panda, whose home name is giant panda, we all know, but its scientific name is Aleuropoda melanoleuca. Its scientific name is. Similarly, we have polar bears. We just know them by the polar bears, but no, its original name or its official name is Ursus maritimus. Then we have this deer, and its name is Ursus erectus. So if you are able to see here, this is also deer, this is also deer. This is polar bear found in the cold or in the snow, and this is grizzly bear found in the forest. If you are able to see here, the first name Ursus is common. Are you getting it? The first name, which is a genus, the genus is common. Ursus. So the Ursus, or you can say genus, may be same, but species are always different. So this is Martimius and this is Arctus. So genus may be same, which is Ursus, but species are always different. Okay. So which two are more closely related? So if you have giant panda, you have polar bear, and you have grizzly bear. So you have given the, you are providing with the scientific name, which is Aleuropoda melanoleuca. We have Ursus maritimus and Ursus arctus. And if someone will ask you, you know, which is more closely related, so you have to know that, so you have to know that we have you know, the genus which is common, we have Ursus and Ursus which is common. So they are these two are more closely related with each other. So let me check whether you are getting it or not. Please tell me, because I am unable to see your faces, so it will be highly appreciated if you respond me. Please. It's just only for the tomorrow, that not only tomorrow but the today's session, so that I am able to know whether you are getting it right or not, because you are new to me and obviously I am new to you. So that is the thing. Please let me know, are you able to get it or not? Okay. We have Golden, who is saying yes ma'am, able to see. We have Moses, yes ma'am, getting it very well. Somushri, yes ma'am. Okay, please just reply. Okay, so it's a very basic, it's just a starting of our lecture series, but by the passing of time it will become little bit difficult also. Okay, so you are getting it. Okay, now let me continue. So we have if you have given Eleuthera and you have given Orsus along with Orsus Arctus, so you will be able to know that these two one are the closely related species. Now we have some rules for naming the organisms, how the taxonomist will be able to name the organism. So these rules are known as International Code for Binomial Nomenclature. So it's an international code. It contains rules for naming the organisms. So what are the rules basically? Yes, basically these organizations which we have, like International Naming Congress or International Zoological Congress, this prevents duplicated names. Okay, like you are giving some name to the organism and another person also giving the name to the same organism but the different name. So this prevents the duplication of the names. So these are the classification group. Basically in the taxonomy we have taxon is a category into which our related organisms are placed. We already discussed that the close ones are always placed together. So there is a hierarchy of groups from broadest to the most specific. So you will able to know that these ones are totally similar, these ones are a little bit different, they are totally different. So there is a hierarchy of the taxa, you can say groups. So we have all these things. We have kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species, which we have to discuss thoroughly. I will tell you everything regarding it in brief. So first we have domain, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. So now our lecture series name is Kingdom Animalia. Kingdom Animalia, it means we have to cover all these things which are there in the kingdom. In kingdom we have phylums. Like we have 9 phylums: phylum Porifera, phylum Cnidaria, phylum Platyhelminthes, Aeschylemynthes, Annelida, Mollusca. So we have 9 phylums. Okay. Within the phylum we have so many of classes. Within the classes we have so many of orders. Within the orders, like in the class Insecta, we have 29 orders, like Lepidoptera, Hemiptera, Diptera. So we have so many of orders, and within the order we have a family. And within the family we have a genus and species. Okay, I will keep it just simple here. We will tell you later. So if you are able to see, this domain is the broadest term, but the species, like Homo sapiens sapiens, the species is always the most specific. So this is a hierarchy of the taxonomic groups. We have domain, we have start from the kingdom. From within the kingdom we have phylum, within the phylum we have classes, within the classes we have so many of orders, and within these orders we have family, genus and species. If you are able to see here, we have grizzly bear, we have black bear, we have giant panda, we have red fox, we have snakes, we have sea star. So what basically they comes under the kingdom Animalia. What do you mean by kingdom Animalia? That in this kingdom we have animal like organisms. Like if you are able to see here, they have 4 legs, they are running, they are moving, they are jumping, everything. So they comes under the, you can say, kingdom Animalia. Within the kingdom Animalia we have phylum Chordata. Within the kingdom Animalia we have the phylum Chordata. So if you are able to see, we have several organisms here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, but within the phylum Chordata, this starfish is absent because it belongs to the phylum Non-Chordata. So in this lecture series, I will cover only non-chordates, and I will definitely propose the chordate series also, in which we will be cover chordates. So within the phylum Chordata we have class Mammalia. So what are basically Mammalia? Those who have the mammary glands, who give birth to the child, who just feed to the child. So all these, this bear and the fox and the squirrel comes under the class Mammalia. And this snake, if you are able to see, this is a coral snake. This will move out. Why? because it belongs to the phylum or it belongs to the class Reptilia, because it's a reptile. Reptiles mean the lizard, the snakes, they all comes under the class reptile. So now it will move out, okay? So it will move out. So the snake will move out because it belongs to class Reptilia. And in the class Mammalia, we have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 organisms left. Now within the class Mammalia, we have order Carnivora. So who comes under Carnivora? Who are able to eat the flesh, or you can say the feeding on the another animal or something like that. So they comes under the order Carnivora. So here the squirrel, this squirrel will move out because this squirrel generally feeds on the fruits or nuts only. So this squirrel moves out. Now within the class, within the order Carnivora, we have a family Oryctidae. Now we have only 3 members in this Oryctidae class, and this fox will move out. Okay, now within the family we have the genus Ursus, in which we have only 2 bears, the grizzly bear and the black bear, and the name of both is different. This is Ursus erectus, this your grizzly bear, and the name of black bear is something different, but of course it will start with Ursus. So the name of genus is there, but the name of species will be different. So this is the whole hierarchy which we have to study. So are you able to get it or not? Please let me know, are you able to get it or not? So this is the whole hierarchy which we have to study. Like we have to study these animals, these you can say the classes, the phylum. Basically my main focus will be on the kingdom Animalia and on the phylum. And in the phylum, like in non-chordates, we have 9 phylums. So I will cover the 9 phylums, okay? So shall we move further? Yes, this is the only the technique to learn everything. Like this is D means domain, K means kingdom, P means phylum, C means class, O means order, S means family, G means genus, and S means species. So you have to remember it in this pattern only. That is why there is a this rhyme that dumb King Philip came over for gooseberry soup. So it's just a rhyme so that you will be able to remember the hierarchy pattern. So dumb King Philip, that means the dumb King Philip came over for gooseberry soup. Okay. So this is the thing in this hierarchy. Let me check whether you are getting it. So are you able to get it? Is it easy or is it difficult? It's very easy thing, very basic thing. So are you able to get it or not? So please tell me the hierarchy now. The pattern of hierarchy, please tell me. If you are here, then please tell me the pattern of hierarchy. Yes, all of you. What's the pattern of hierarchy? We have bison, we have falguni, golden. Please let me know the pattern of hierarchy. Yes, Natasha, please let me know the pattern of hierarchy. Yes, very good, very good, very good. Yes, domain, then we have kingdom, we have phylum, class, order, family, genus, and the species. So this is the pattern of hierarchy. So the dumb king, you know, the dumb king Philips. You have to remember the lines, then you will be able to write the pattern of hierarchy also. Yes, Shivangi, very good. So you have to remember things, saying that within the class we have, within one class we have so many of orders, and then within one order we have so many of families, then within one family we have so many of genus, then within one genus we have so many of species. So just remember this thing. Yes, Shubham is also with us. Very good, Shubham. Pipin, very good. Yes, yes, we have genus and then we have a species. So are you getting it? Everything is clear till now? Please let me know. Yes, golden, very good. Domain, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. Very good, very good. Golden. Yes, Jeet. Oh, good afternoon, Jeet. How are you? Are you able to get it? Because you are also new to this thing. Yes, we have Abaida who is saying yes, ma'am. Okay, very good, very good. So yes, so shall we continue? We will just do something more. Yes, yes, Moses, you are right, very good. So we have the pattern. We have to remember only one thing, that is, this thing, dumb king Philip came over for gooseberry soup. Dumb King Philip came over for gooseberry soup. If you remember this rhyme, then you will be able to correctly know the hierarchy. Okay. Then we have classification of humans. Or you can say how our name Homo sapiens is basically our original, or you can say the scientific name. So if I will start from the kingdom, it belongs to the kingdom Animalia, in which we have lots of animals or lots of organisms are there who are multicellular, motile and who ingest their food. And then it belongs to the phylum Chordata, who has dorsal spotting rod and nerve cord. Belongs to the class kingdom Animalia, phylum Chordata, class Mammalia. Why they are known as mammalians? Because they have the mammary glands. They have the ability to, you know, feed the baby or the newborn baby. So they are belongs to the class Mammalia. Order is primates. Why it belongs to the order primates? Because they have the ability to climb the trees. Family Hominidae, adapted to walk erect, because we are not four-legged organisms. We are only two-legged organisms. And we are able to, you know, walk very straight. And we belong to the genus Homo. Now, what are the characters of the genus Homo? We have the large brain and we have the ability to use the tools. Like we have the ability to use so many of tools which are like firing and every another tools, like for your defense and other purposes also. So we have the large brain and we have the ability to use the tools. And what do you mean by Homo sapiens? It is the body proportions of modern humans. We are not Homo sapiens as usual, like our ancestors are Homo erectus, Homo australopithecus. So there is an evolution. But on this stage where we are now, we have Homo sapiens. Okay. So are you able to get me? We have Homo sapiens. So we have the kingdom Animalia. Then we are chordates, belongs to the class Mammalia. Order is primates, family is Hominidae, genus is Homo and the species is Homo sapiens. So this is our scientific name basically. So sometimes these things are also important, you have to know it. So domain is basically what domain is, the broadest term, the very broadest in which you put everything. Like this is the organism, suppose this is the moving organism, then put it in this domain. This is the standing organism like plants, then put it in this domain. So we have, it's a very broadest term, we have three domains. We have Araki, Bacteria and Eukarya. In Araki and Bacteria we have only the prokaryotes, which are basically the bacteria, the viruses. So they are unicellular prokaryotes. In Eukarya we have the more complex and have a nucleus and a membrane bound organelles. In Eukarya we have plants and animals. So these are known as domains. Now we will just discuss all these domains like Araki, Bacteria and Eukarya. In Araki domain we have the kingdom which is known as Araki Bacteria. They are the first cells to evolve. Araki Bacteria, they are the only the first, when there is the evolution of the earth, when there is a formation of the earth, they are the first one who come first or who are the first cells, the Araki Bacteria, which evolve. So they live in harsh environments. They generally found in sewage or in the presence of methanogens, in thermal or volcanic vents, in very salty water or dead seas. So they are the very primitive type of bacteria. Then we have, this is the one example of this bacteria, which is Methanosarcina mizai. So these are found in the very, you can say, very intolerable environments, like in harsh conditions. Then we have bacteria. We all know about bacteria. They cause us many diseases. They are found in all habitats. So they are generally also found in our yogurt. The dahi which we are eating is also consists of these small microorganisms. Even in the buttermilk, which is our chach, or you can say buttermilk, or in cottage cheese. So we have bacteria everywhere surrounding us. So if you are able to see this diagram, these are the bacteria which are found in our own intestine, that is inside the human. So these type of bacteria, they live in the intestine of animals. Like we have Escherichia coli. This is a bacteria, not only single but a number of cells of bacteria. They are found in the intestine of the animals, or you can say in the humans. Then we have last domain, which is Eukarya, in which we have protista, we have fungi, we have plantae and we have animalia. So in this domain we put mushrooms, we put plants, we put fungi, we put animals, everything puts under this, because the first two one are just consist of microorganisms like bacteria, or all these creatures come under the first two domains. But in this domain we have everything. We have fungi, we have plants, trees, flowers, animals, snakes, everything comes under this domain. So the number one is protista, or you can say algae. They are generally aquatic. These type of organisms, they are generally found under the water. Then we have fungi. We all know about mushrooms, we all eat the mushrooms also. So they also come under this domain, and their cell walls are made up of chitin, a substance which is a hard, and it's made up in the cell walls are made up of chitin. Then we have plantae. From the name we are able to know that we have the plants here in this domain. Okay, so we have the plants. Then in animalia, what do you mean by animalia? So this is the mother, the bird mother feeding their young ones. So in mammalia, in animalia we have animals basically. So this is the you can say kingdoms, protista, fungi, plantae and animalia, which comes under the domain Eukarya. Okay, so these type of organisms, we have protozoans, we have algae, we have water molds here in the protista. In the fungi we have mushrooms, in molds and yeast. In plantae we have plants, we have flowering plants, and in animalia we have the fishes, reptiles, amphibians, birds and mammals. So all these things come under the kingdom Animalia, which we have to study very thoroughly. That is why the name of this lecture series is Kingdom and Emilia, because we have to explore all these things, the fishes, the reptiles, the snakes and everything. Okay, it comes under the Kingdom and Emilia, and today is only the introductory round, or you can say introduction. So in the Kingdom and Emilia, which we have to study, we have, you know, 1/4 or more than 1/4 portion which is covered by insects. So we will discuss them thoroughly. So then we have some other animals which will cover some part. Then this is the whole kingdom Plantae, Kingdom Animalia, Kingdom Myocota, Kingdom Eubacteria. So rest are, you know, very small or very few in number, but insects are very large in number. So it is the jelly. The saying nowadays that the only competitors of humans or the Homo sapiens are basically insects, because insects are so large in number and they can cause us, even they are causing us lots of problems. So the only competitor of humans right now is insects. Like we have dengue virus, we have malaria, and we have so many diseases from these insects that they are our competitors. So then we have basis of modern taxonomy. This is basically how we are just put the organisms together, like they are saying homologous structure, that they same structure but difference in function. The structure is same, but because of the environmental conditions, because of the situation, but the structure is same, but they adapted differently. Now let me show you. Like here we have human, we have cheetah, we have whale and bat. If you are able to see here, the human used his forearms for the purpose of running, or you can say the purpose of any type of activity. Cheetah is only using it for running. So they have actually the similar type of structures instead of the hands. Here the hands are joined together. Why they are joined together? Because sometimes they have to use it for the jumping purpose also. In case of whales, this is again the same, the arm reason, you can say four limbs, but the structure is highly different because it is used for the swimming purpose. Here we are using it for the regular activity, cheetah is using it for the running purpose, whale is using it for the swimming purpose, and bat is using it for the flying purpose. So the four limb is same, but now if you are able to see here, there is a modification in the four limbs. Like here the hands are this one, but in case of whales this is the larger one. In case of bats also this is the, you know, most important one or the larger one. So these are the homologous organisms. Similarly, we have some similarities in the embryos also, but it's basically the embryos which are found inside the mother, or the after the zygotic stage. So if you are able to see here, in the very first this is the zygote, the male and female, you can say the fusion of male and female cells. So in the very few weeks all are similar, but after some months have passed, they have, you know, just started to change their shape. Like in this case of tortoise, here comes the outer shape, tortoise. This is the embryo of our hen, this is the embryo of pig, this is the embryo of human, and this is the embryo of whale. So in the very basic stages, if you are able to see here, in the very basic stages they are almost same, but only in the last months they get changed. It means they all have the, you can say, they have the similar origin, or they all arise from the same thing or same region. I will show you one another diagram. So like this is a cladogram, if you are able to see here, this one. So they all are similar at some aspect, they all are similar. Like this human is more close to this chimpanzee, if you are able to see here. Okay, before it we have this rhesus monkey, but after rhesus monkey we have the loss of tail. The tail gets lost and this chimpanzee and this human has no tail and they are little bit more close to each other. You must have seen those the movie which is on apes. I think the Planet of the Apes maybe. So they are more close to each other and they are just like humans, but the humans you can say little bit adapt more. Okay, so this rhesus monkey and this chimpanzee are also similar because they are both in, they are just using their four legs or their four arms also, but they have, in the case of chimpanzee, there's a loss of tail. But what is similarity between both of them? Downward pointing nose. So both of them have the downward pointing nose. Okay, then we have this spider monkey and this rhesus monkey. This monkey and this monkey is quite resembling with each other, or is a very, you can say, very close to each other. But how? In case of the spider monkey or in the rhesus monkey, we have central eye area for acute vision. So this is a resemblance in between both of these. Then we have ring-tailed lemur. What are the common features there? Four kinds of teeth, movable head and front-facing eyes, large brain, omnivorous, five digits on the hand and foot with opposite thumb. So these all, you know, all characters are found in us. That four kinds of teeth, incisors, canines, dentines, molars and premolars. So these all things are found in these also. That is why they are comes under one tree. Movable head with front facing eyes. This is in us also, and even in this, even in this, even in this, and even in this. Large brain is present in all of the five. Omnivorous, that means they can eat anything. Five digits on the hand and foot. Yes, we have five digits with opposable thumb, but the thumb is the opposite one. So this is the pattern of evolution. This is the way how we come to know about the evolution, how we are growing. Okay, and who our ancestors are. By this type of cladograms we are able to know that we are quite similar with our ancestor ones. So I think then another we have dichotomous key. I will not start it today. I will just keep it simple up to here that we have to do the cladogram and we must know the what the cladogram is basically. Okay, so basically they all are generally same, but they adapted according to the situation or according to the environmental condition in which they are living. So are you able to understand this this cladogram tree or not? This tree, are you able to understand it? Please let me know. Please let me know if you are able to understand it, please. I am just waiting for your replies. I'm not just doing it very fast because it's our first lecture and I just want to keep it very simple today. Okay, so that it will not become burden to you also. Just I keep it very, very simple. So I hope you all get it and I hope you all satisfied with the today's lecture. Okay, you are getting it. So we have here, after it we have to do lots of another things. We have to do dichotomous thing and then we will doing the classification of living things. Again the same thing, why we classify, and Aristotle is there who classify the plants and animals in 2000 years ago. Then this is again the classification part, the jellyfish. Let me do something more. Okay, so like jellyfish, because we have done it already, so just I'm doing it some one time more. Like jellyfish is not a true fish. So this jellyfish is basically the non-chordate and it belongs to the phylum Coelenterata, but till it comes under the, its name is jellyfish. So that is why we need the classification, we need taxonomy. Like this is, these are trees. We have silver maple, we have sugar maple and we have red maple, are each different species. So this is another species, this is another and this is another, but the name are almost same. Like silver maple, sugar maple and red maple, but they are the different species. Similarly, we have these, by the 17th 1700 scientists realized that common names were very confusing. So if I am giving you only a single name or common name, then it's very confusing that whether they are same or the one organism, or whether they are two or they are different organisms. So that is why we have to give them the names, the scientific names. Okay. So Linnaeus is the one who is known as father of taxonomy. Okay. Let me show you. This we have done: domain, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family. We already discussed it. That is the tree. That is, we have bacteria. These are the domains. We have bacteria, we have archaea, and we have eukarya. In eukarya we have plants, animals, fungi and protista. So in eukarya we have plants, animals, fungi and protista. So we have different kinds of domains. We have already discussed it. Then we will start with the phylums now. Let me check here one minute. So we have, yes, we will start that what's the classification is a grouping of living organism according to the characters. That according to the characters, either they are four leg or two leg, they are grouped. Okay. So like we have domestic animals. So in the early time, the people just put the animals in five groups. Domestic animals like cat, dog, our donkey, they comes under domestic animals. Then we have wild animals like elephant, or you can say rhinoceros. These all comes under wild animals. Then we have creeping animals like this snake or lizard. They comes under creeping animals. Then we have flying animals. We have sea animals, flying which fly like birds, and sea animals which are found in the sea. But this is the five group classification by the ancestral ones, but this is not a correct one. So Aristotle is the one who just classify the organisms very well. So animal kingdom is divided into two groups. Okay, so tomorrow we will start with this animal kingdom two groups: vertebrates and invertebrates. Okay, so tomorrow we will start with our vertebrates and invertebrates. But we have today just discussed about the classification. What is classification? What is the need of classification? Why are we are doing the classification? So that there should not be any type of misnomers. Then one more thing which we have done is the taxonomy. What is basically taxonomy? What is binomial nomenclature? And how to describe the hierarchy of the hierarchical system? Like we have domains, we have kingdom, phylum, class, order, family. Okay, genus and species. So these all are the very basic things which we have discussed today. I hope you all will get it. So please let me know, are you get it or not? Please let me know. Please, if you are able to listen to me, then please let me know, are you able to get it? Yes, please tell me. Okay, good. So you are getting it. So I will just keep it simple. Tomorrow we will meet again on the same time, but with the two types of animals or organisms in the kingdom Animalia, that is invertebrates and vertebrates. Invertebrates, also known as non-chordates, I will cover it in this lecture series. For chordates, I will make the another lecture series. Okay. Yes. So you all are getting it. So then it's very good if you are getting it. If you have any type of query, you can also let me know. There is not any problem at all. You can share anything with me. We are here for your, even for every for the purpose of knowledge, and knowledge is just sharing basically. So if I have some knowledge, I am just sharing with all of you. If you have some knowledge or if you want to share something, then you are highly welcomed, or you are highly appreciated if you have something to say or some knowledge. So you are most welcome. So that's all for today from my side. Tomorrow we will meet again on the same time, that is from 3 PM, or maybe a little bit early, that is from 2:45. We will just get on online by 2:45 PM, because I know you all are in your homes. So that's all from my side. Are you able to get it today? Everything is fine. Yes. So there is one more request to all of you, that please like the videos, because we put lots of efforts to make the good videos or the good PPTs for all of you. And also please subscribe my channel, which is Crash Courses, so that you will be able to know when I get online or when I get live. You will be able to know. So just subscribe my channel, which is Crash Courses, and also like the videos. It will be, you know, such a kindness of you all if you will do this thing. Just subscribe the channel so that you will be able to see the link, and you will able to know when I just get live, because I have many sessions which I have to do in a day. So you will get knowledge from every session. That is my only motive. So that's all from my side. We will meet tomorrow. Till then, take care of yourself, and a very, very good evening from my side. Okay. So yes, we have Liston, we have Nature, we have Shubham, Falguni, Golden, Natasha, Shivangi, Somoshri, Kumarjeet. So I thank you all. And yes, please, no need to say thank you. It's not only a teacher-student relationship. We are just like a friend. So no need of thank you, and you are always welcome. Just take care of yourself, okay? So just take care of yourself and be happy. Yes, Divyani, you will get the presentation, you will get everything, no issues at all. You have not to take any type of worry or tension. You have to remain happy always, okay? So that's all from my side. We will meet tomorrow, and please subscribe my channel. And also like the videos. Okay. So now I'm just going end stream, because I have to go home, and we will meet tomorrow. Okay. Yes. Okay. Bye to all. We have Somoshri, we have Golden, Kumar, Shivangi, Listan, Divyani, Bibin, Falguni, Nature, and Abaida. So bye to all of you. We will meet tomorrow. Okay. So just I am now going. Yes. Bye to all. Bye.